The goal of a military advisor is to help in the film and to bring realism, you know, authenticity, believability. It starts early on at the script level and sometimes continues on all the way to editing to advise on, you know, which takes were the most, you know, correct when it comes to tactics and weapons and things like that. We start with going and taking notes on, you know, what's realistic, what's believable, what's not. And then trying to find the balance between, you know, what is entertaining, what is real. You know, if there's a chance to make something real and not take away from the creative vision of the writer and the director, you know, that's kind of what we want to do every time. So after going to that, then we look at the actors and the training. So we schedule time with them before we start shooting, do training with them. And then we go into shooting and looking at the monitors and seeing what's the best way to make it look real, make it be believable. So the audience, which is becoming more and more sophisticated, buys it. The biggest thing I like is his research and attention to detail in his novels. I'll give you one example. In the novel, which didn't make it into the script, but in the novel, he describes the obstacle course that the recruits go through. And when I read it, I knew that he must have been to the Navy SEAL training compound because every obstacle was described in detail with the correct name and description all the way through. So doing that means he cared enough to go down there, you know, watch people go through it. He may have gone through it himself, I'm not sure, but and write that down. And you know, a lot of times writers have an opportunity to make stuff up. And every chance I think that he gets to get it real, he takes and puts it in his novels.